In an era where uncrewed aerial systems, UASs, have proliferated and flourished on battlefields from Europe to the Red Sea, the technical challenge now is not so much to weaponize UASs as to eliminate them effectively and cheaply. Hence, the Australian Defence's project LAND156, Counter Small Uncrewed Aerial Systems, C-S-UAS, which is now underway. Defence's aim is to identify and then disable or destroy small drones on the battlefield as quickly and cheaply as possible. That means without using expensive anti-air or anti-missile missiles unless absolutely necessary. The project's timeline would see a systems integration partner providing a baseline counter-small uncrewed aerial systems capability by the end of 2025 and a complete minimum viable capability by the end of 2030. The successful company will be Defence's strategic partner and must deliver a developmental command and control system, including the vital situational awareness that is capable of integrating all of the sensors and effectors acquired by the end of this year, under what Defence terms a capability target state 1. The system must also be able to integrate any sensors and effectors acquired subsequently, at least to the end of 2030. The main threat are drones with a maximum weight of about 25 kilograms and a maximum speed of about 250 knots. A drone that size can conduct intelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance missions, or attack anything from individual tanks and vehicles to flight lines with aircraft worth multiple millions of dollars. Defence wants a low cost per kill, with a very low chance of fratricide and an ability to integrate the C-S-UAS system with short-range ground-based air defence and integrated air and missile defence systems, both the ADFs and those of its allies. Nearly 80% of these small drones can be disrupted by electronic jamming, and that's what Australian counter-UAS and situational awareness specialist DroneShield specialises in. Its passive omnidirectional RfPatrol Mk2 detects drones out to a range of 4 kilometres, while its directional DroneGun Mk4 jams the Wi-Fi, or global system for mobile control and navigation signals, controlling hostile drones out to a range of 1 kilometre. A bigger version has a range of 2 kilometres. The DroneGun Mk4 can also handle drone swarms because its effects are not focused on a single target. Anything within its operational range and field of regard is affected equally. Depending on their pre-programmed control logic, and if the jamming signal is maintained, drones would probably either fly autonomously back to their launch site or simply sink to the ground. An agile force can exploit either outcome. The situational awareness tools deployed by DroneShield are based around the Drone Sentry C2, Enterprise Command and Control System, which can handle multiple sites, RfPatrol Mk2, and the Drone Sentry X Mk2 radar. That toolset helps build up a real-time picture of drone activity in a specific area, even if the drone concerned don't use RF signals for guidance and detonation, and it can integrate other sensors and effectors as these become available. The evolution of drone warfare is making hard kill systems essential. DroneShield says it can integrate systems such as the M230 Bushmaster 30mm cannon and high-energy laser from EOS Defense's Titanis, and the AIM Defense Fractal high-power anti-drone laser. These can counter drones that don't employ Wi-Fi or GSM communications control signals. A growing number of relatively short-range drones are also using wire guidance, similar to a Milan or TOW anti-tank missile, to avoid radio emissions and interference. The Australian Defence Force has signed a 3-year contract with DroneShield's rival Anduril to trial its C-UAS system at RAAF Base Darwin. Anduril's offering is based on the capability as a service business model it is using, a systems integration partner in the US Special Operations Command CUXS program. Delivered in just 15 weeks, Anduril's Darwin system is powered by the company's well-understood Lattice OS open architecture software platform, which lies at the heart of other capabilities, such as the Ghost Shark XLAUV it is developing for the Royal Australian Navy in Sydney. DroneShield is offering a similar business model, suggesting it could deliver Anduril's functionality at a significantly lower price. It is negotiating an agreement with services company Ventia to conduct 24/7 monitoring, and believes it could deliver base solutions within 6 months of contract award and complete the rollout to as many as 104 separate ADF bases in 18 to 24 months. Project LAND156 is an important step toward Australia's baseline defence against small drones on the battlefield by 2030. Thanks for watching. And if you appreciate what we are doing, please subscribe and support us by checking out our merchandise shop.